Dr. Nick Delgado here with Dr. Michael Grossman. Dr. Grossman, I'm going to go over a rapid fire series of things that I think our viewers can benefit from. First off, and in this particular order, in my own experience, the power of the mind, the mindset, being able to utilize the subconscious mind program through meditation, through NLP, timeline therapy, really jumping in there, maybe having a few sessions, coming on board with these, but learning how to redirect the mind instead of getting into kind of a negative mindset, like, I just don't know how to handle this, and really searching for things in a time when people are troubled. They're having a lot of stress, more stress than at any time that I can remember in my lifetime. So do these interventions for the mind truly not only change the effect on the body, but more importantly, the happiness, the quality of life? And then maybe that helps a person to stay more consistent with their exercise, their diet, their need for optimizing their hormones, and how it impacts their career. So the mindset, you as a medical doctor, you came to a realization of how important the mind is. You even do weekly meditation programs. Why is the mind so important? And why are so many people unclear of how to direct the mind to get the results they want?
Process of having your mind focused on creating and enjoying is a critical part of your health. Stress is the most important factor in what makes you sick. And you have to deal with that. And it's not something that comes up in traditional medicine. It doesn't make anybody money. There's no great financial value to it. But for your own personal growth and development, it's critical. We have so much research on meditation, so much research on the quality of your personal relationships, which are essential and critical to your health and well-being. I love teaching meditation classes, and I do it twice a week. And I find that it changes the experience of the people who come to the class, and they learn to meditate on their own. Every time you get stressed, emotionally stressed by whatever's going on in your life, it changes your physiology. You excrete all kinds of hormones and chemicals into the blood that are stress hormones, and that changes the way your whole body functions. Stress is designed so when a lion is running after you, you can stop thinking about the upset you had with anybody at home. You stop thinking about your plans for the future. Your brain shuts off all the ideas and the abstract thought, and you just start thinking about that tree you want to jump in really fast, and the body turns off all of the digestion. You don't need to digest your food. You need to have energy going into your muscles so you can jump real fast. The immune system, you don't need to worry about any bacteria or any viruses. You just want to survive in the next minute. When you're under constant stress, you keep on shutting those things down. And that causes all kinds of disease processes. You've got to learn to unstress yourself. And that's a very important process. You cannot overlook it.